Good morning, Elliot. You say hi.
Uh-oh.
Beautiful. Destroy.
Okay, well, that's keeping her busy. Do my skincare. Show you my morning skincare routine. Aloha, kikahiaka. Oh gosh. Oh, I went out with some girls last night. We might have had a shot of tequila. My morning routine, a really great routine and habit to get into to kind of like wake your face up and to look really nice. First of all, for starters, when it comes to washing your face, I don't know, Elliot is still playing with those rings. I'm sure you can hear it. When it comes to skincare, I think a lot of people don't know about the double cleanse. I'm sure you've seen on like your shampoo bottles and stuff where it says wash, rinse, repeat. The first time you wash your hair, it gets all the dirt and the crap off. The second time you wash it, it actually lathers it, penetrates your scalp, and does a really great job washing your actual hair once you got off the grime. It's the same thing for your skin. So it's really, really important actually to cleanse twice. They have a lot of cleansers that are like pre-cleansers. Dermalogica has an amazing pre-cleanse. I just ran out, I need to order more. I didn't wanna take the one from my spa because I didn't wanna like risk forgetting it and not bringing it back. I have this, it's called Juice Beauty 2-in-1 Cleanser. It's organic and it's something that I got in Marin County, and it's a Marin County based family owned company. I was into that when I last time I went to visit my parents, so I got that. It's like a really soft, simple cleanser, and I use it as my first cleanse to kind of get all the dirt off of my face. I just got it a little bit wet. Just getting the dirt off is the key to the first cleanse. Prepping your skin so that your cleanser can actually penetrate, it's super important. It's also, if you think about it, if you're wearing a lot of makeup, whether it's at night or you forgot it from the night before, this is gonna kind of break off the breakup and get off the makeup, and then the cleanser will wash you. Do you remember that famous Kylie Jenner video where she was like doing her own skincare and she cleansed her face and then she patted her face in her towel and it was like full of makeup? She didn't double cleanse. Another great benefit of the cleanse is that you're gonna get more hot water and you're giving your pores a better chance to open up. If you do need to do any extractions or get any spots on your face, you're giving yourself the best setup possible for that. I always try to explain to my clients, if you need to pop your own pimples, prep your skin. There's a time and a place. Your pores need to be open, your skin needs to be clean, and your hands need to be clean in order for it to come out. Otherwise, it's like pushing someone through a closed door. And that's how you're gonna get scabs, scarring. You're not gonna get everything out, and it's gonna actually last longer. So if you really do wanna get rid of like a pimple or any kind of blemish, do a double cleanse, exfoliate, and use really warm water or hot compress, and that will really open up the pores, and it will just kind of walk out, if you will. Hi! You wanna do skincare with mommy? You do? Yeah? Yeah?
Okay.
Okay, here, let me put a towel down. Yeah, you're gonna help me. Okay, you sit right there. But you can't touch. Okay, here. Here's your favorite cup. There you go. Next, we're going in. Second cleanse, special cleansing gel. Really simple. I'm actually getting ready to upgrade into an Age Smart line and to start doing things to kind of prevent my wrinkles from getting worse. My crow's feet are really out of control. They look worse when my skin's dry. So if you have nourished skin, your wrinkles are gonna show up less. All these things that you can do to make yourself look just a little bit younger. So, oh, do your skincare.
He needs you.
What?
Ben needs you.
Ben?
Yeah, he's crying.
The dog's crying?
He needs you.
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's alright.
Okay, Elia.
He just wants his mommy.
Hi.
Hi. Okay. Back to the cleanser. Peace eyes. I like to lather it in my hands first, kind of foams it up. This is a soap-free cleanser. Good for all skin types. Really gentle, no acids. Really gets a lot of impurities. Like I said, helps open up those pores, cleans it all out. And that double cleanse, that first cleanse, it really starts with the blood circulation and it helps get it all moving. So by the time you're doing the second one, the blood's pumping in your face and you're already looking more awake. A lot of like face massage can really stimulate blood flow, drain your lymph. Yeah, baby, that's right. Can mommy turn the water on? Oh. Can you sit? Sit up here. You all done? Thank you. Rinse this off. Between washes, I never like grab a paper towel or anything. Your face is just gonna get wet again, so like don't waste it. Wait till then. Next step is exfoliating. Daily microfoliant. The rice enzymes are so fine that you can use it every day, even twice a day. Most exfoliants are like really gritty and that will tear your skin. You should only do those twice a week or get something that's finer and more gentle. The rice enzymes are the physical. Salicylic acid is the chemical, so it does a really great job. This is one of my favorite exfoliants of all time. However, it's intimidating. It is a powder. Oh, baby. You want some toothpaste for your... You want some toothpaste? There you go. Okay, back to the exfoliant. It's a powder, really wet hands. Don't like put them in the water and leave them dripping. Don't even shake them off. Just put the powder into your hands and start rubbing. Put it straight on your face. It will lather. I like to rub 60 to 90 seconds or until I can't feel the rice enzymes anymore, because they're like, you can feel them. The physical exfoliant, and I like to rub until it's kind of like, you know, dissolving. Always get your neck. Okay. Oh, don't put that in the toilet, honey. Okay. We're making our way. Use a paper towel. Don't use your hand towel. There's so much bacteria on your hand towel. Don't use a dirty towel to dry your clean face. Yeah, babe.
Can I have my own deodorant?
I stinky. Anyway, order is so important for your skincare. Double cleanse, exfoliate, and then tone. This is a Dermalogica multi-active toner. Restores the pH balance of your face, closes your pores, help with product absorption. Don't skip this step. Toner is so important, and don't get one with alcohol in it. It's not good for your skin. If you use any products that make your face sting, throw them away. They don't work for you. They're not good. And I know that it's hard and sometimes unrealistic to spend a lot of money on skincare. However, once you buy high quality products, you're gonna wish that you just invested in them a long, long time ago, because—
Yeah, bitch.
All that, all the—
Eat it. Sorry. Eat it, girl. She's like digging through the trash. No, eat it. I love you, but you're digging through the trash. You're better than that.
You're better than that. Okay, sorry, back to what I was saying about high quality skincare. It makes all the difference. First of all those products have so many additives. Most exfoliants in stores have like plastic in it and stuff like that. Just don't do it. If you can, go for, like, try to get sample sizes. Most websites you can get like free things to try. With Dermalogica, they have travel sizes. The travel size cleanser, it's only $12. You could get a whole skincare regimen for like $60. It'll last you like, you know, a month or two. And you can at least try the products and at least realize the difference in the good quality skincare. And then be like, okay, I'm gonna invest in myself. Skincare is all about like self-love, and you really, really need to take care of your skin. Especially as we're getting older, the best ways to prevent aging, I'm just saying, like, by exfoliating and keeping your cell renewal really high. It's gonna fill in lines. It's gonna make you look more awake. Your skin tone's gonna be more even. You're just gonna love your skin more. And the thing is the less makeup you wear, the less damage it's gonna do to your skin over time. It behooves you to just get some high quality skincare. I promise you. I promise, promise, promise you. Enough with my lecture. Toner's done its thing. This is my new secret weapon. It's my first serum that I'm gonna be using today. It's the Power Bright Dark Spot Serum by Dermalogica. Can you see it? Okay, so do you see this? This is sun damage that I got when I was pregnant. When you're really hormonal, your skin's a little more prone to dark spots. So this pigmentation here, and then I also have a pigmentation problem here. And that happened when I actually got my lip lasered. When you get laser, you can get really easy pigmentation problems. I just put one pump into my hand. I start in the areas I want, but I put it all over. It's sort of serum you let it in. I only use this one in the morning, but it's really been helping lighten it up. You wanna let it absorb for about a minute. Most serums, you wanna let them absorb individually on their own. So we're gonna let this one absorb. My next step is my Mindy Walters Oil Complex. It's so restorative. It makes me look so bright. I feel like it really helps me look more plump. I just do 3-4 drops. I think I just did a little bit too much. But again, rub it in and bring it down all the way down my neck. Already looking so much better. Thank Jesus. Let that set in for a minute. Okay, let's review. Cleanse, exfoliate, tone, target. Those are the serums. You target first underneath your moisturizer. Underneath, and let each one set in. You don't need to use more than one. The dark spot one is very specific, but I really like the oil complex because it gives me just such a brighter face that I use too. And if you are not into serums, I have things to say about serums. There are so many wonderful, wonderful things that you can put onto your skin that are like instant firming, or just like make it so much more youthful, stimulate collagen production, that like just will fill in fine lines, make you brighter, just make you look younger. And all of these things are preventative measures, so that, as you know, I'm 31, I want to stay looking 31. Or fuck it, I want to look 15. You know what I mean? Like, and this is a way that you can do it, is with really taking care of your skin. I know I'm like a broken record, but like, I want to hit it home. You can prevent like signs of aging with good skincare and a really good skincare routine. So like, get on it. You're only hindering yourself if you don't do it. Okay. My next is my moisturizer. It's another Dermalogica product. So it's called Intensive Moisture Balance. It's good actually for combination skin size or a little bit more. Really let it rub into your skin. Don't rub it on your hands first. Don't let your hands steal it. It's for your face. You can glob, glob, glob and then wipe, but massage. Get it in, let it penetrate, but also, oh my gosh, face massage feels so good. Stimulates the blood flow. It just starts moving things. It makes you look more awake, and you won't have dark circles. They won't pool. You want to move things. Don't you want to look awake? Last step is sunscreen. Right now I'm using Kula, and it's Reef Safe. It's SPF 50. This is lightweight, non-greasy. It's the white tea scent. It's like $35. Oh my gosh, that was way too much. Shit. Whoops. Okay, well, again, don't rub it into your hands. I like to... This is so much crap. Wasting.
Mama.
Yeah, baby?
Watching pink sweats. She climbed up on the table and just...
You want some sunscreen? I put too much in my hand.
Shit.
It's for your face.
But she's like... She's watching pink sweats.
You still want me to learn on the piano so we can sing it together?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I can learn it later.
Mm-hmm.
I have a full set of eyelash extensions at 2 o'clock today, but I'll be pal by 4.
What's the daycare situation? Is it me again?
China's coming.
What time?
At 9, I believe.
Okay, cool.
Hi.
Look at mommy's putting in sunscreen. Rub, rub, rub. Yeah, I need you my hair. You wanna help me? Mm-hmm. Okay. You put sunscreen? I broke the cap, that's why. You see all the sand in there? Oh, don't put that in your mouth. No.
Hi.
Okay, come in. You gonna sit up here, be a good girl while mommy does her hair? Yeah? Yeah? Okay, here, sit right there. I don't like to spend time on my hair. It's long and sometimes I wear it down. Sometimes it's hot and I don't want to, and especially like if my skincare gets my hair really, really wet like this, I don't want to wear it down today. So I'm gonna put it up. And actually, my little sister Julia dubbed this the cool girl bun. It's like a slick low bun instead of just like slicking it back. She cheats this little part in the front, like a little middle part, only like 2 inches or so. No, an inch and a half. Okay, and then I steal away Leia's pomade.
What?
I use it on my hair.
I was wondering why it was hot. I was like,
I didn't use that much. I'll get you more. I bought that for you. Whatever. Are you going poo? I can hear it. Okay, I slicked down this middle part. It looks so sketchy right now. Waylia says when I wear a middle part, I look like a pilgrim. What are you doing, Elia? Give me this. Noah, stop. Oh my gosh. Elia, no. Stop! I know. Oh. Okay. You're fine. Let's get this a little bit wet because this is poofy hair. So I got my sketch mini part. As I was saying, YLS is my little part. Makes me look like a pilgrim. A cute pilgrim. So I'm doing my pilgrim bun today. Julia calls it the cool girl bun. I call it the pilgrim bun. Last time I got my hair trimmed, she did some kind of angled bangs, which I always regret. I don't know why I continue to do that to myself. I did, and it is what it is. So I secure it first with a rubber band because just a bun doesn't work. Okay, and then I kind of twist, bring it around, another hair tie. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, I'm like sweating. I'm not sweating, I'm sparkling. It's cute, right? Thanks, Juge. Appreciate it. Let's get dressed. I don't have that much time before work. Come on, Elia. Just my little magnet. And I love it, obviously. You got your cups? I think I know what I want to wear. So you can really see that pigmentation in the natural light. My goal is to light this up. Chemical peels would actually really help me. I'd love to do a series of chemical peels on myself, or I could do it on myself. I'm gonna get dressed. Okay, so I just went with this like simple white tank and some like high-waisted mom jeans. They're cropped. This is not a fashion vlog, but I'm just showing you my work outfit. Super simple. We're gonna throw on some earrings. Baby. Yeah, baby? Right. Yeah.
I'll be right in.
Are you smoking a cigarette out there?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Why, what's wrong?
Nothing, I can smell it. Yeah. Okay. Some earrings.
I got my heirloom bracelet on that Wayla got me for Mother's Day. The earrings always jazz it up. Okay, this little necklace my mother-in-law gave me for Christmas. These were like $14. There's this store called Mahina there. My whole outfit is from there. My tank top, which I think was like $27. My jeans were $55. Perfume I'm gonna put on today, Gabrielle by Chanel. I love this. Wayla got this for me for Christmas. I don't wear makeup to work unless I have like bad blemishes. I hate makeup. I hate what it does to my skin. I hate the way that it makes me look. The only thing I do is fill in my brows. And this is like the saddest excuse. This is like the poorest excuse for a pencil. Like it's literally at the end, but all my brow stuff's at work. So I just, and it literally lightly fill them in. I will admit, when I first started my apprenticeship, I didn't really learn a lot about shaping brows, just basic trimming and waxing. I didn't know any better, obviously. And during the pandemic, I decided to take a brow course, and it like totally changed everything that I understand about brows and the symmetry of your face. And it's what's inspired me to want to learn microblading, which I'm doing in August, and I can't wait to be certified. So I've been like reshaping my brows. They were just on like a different path. I'd like get them back on course. I do a little bit pencil just for the shadow underneath so that they look more full. I don't really make, like I don't shape them with the pencil. I just get a little bit in the shadow where those areas are sparse. I don't really try too hard when it comes to this. That's all I do. I'm gonna use Dr. Hauschka chapstick. My sisters and I used to get this at Whole Foods. It's like a $20 chapstick. I probably had this for like 4 years. But it's so sweet and soft. I'm just in the mood to do it. I'm thinking I'm just showing off because I'm like doing a get ready with me. I never wear this. That's why I've had it for 4 years. Grab some of these because.
Hi, baby. Hi, sweet baby.
Hi,
hey, that's not your. Hey, this is not your drawer. This is your drawer. You already took all your stuff out of there.
Can you put your toys away, Elia?
How about that one? One, woo, two, three, try it out. Four, five, yay! One more time. Give it a good, give it another try. Watch your head, though. Watch it, right here. Put it inside.
All
good
right! Good job!
High five.
Abba! It would be a good idea, too.
Oh shit, I gotta be at work. I have my first appointments in 10 minutes. I got too carried away with getting ready. Obviously it's really hard with the baby. So Ben has a hotspot. I need to call the vet. I'm one street over from my studio, so it's only gonna take me 2 minutes to get there. It's 8:23, my first appointment's at 8:30. So I'm gonna rush over there, I'm gonna call the vet. Hi there, I am calling. My dog has like a pretty gnarly hot spot on his neck, like under where his collar was. I'm just wondering if there's any way I could bring him in today for you guys to just take a look at it. And
we don't have any appointments.
Okay, do you have any recommendations?
Okay, I'll go ahead and ask and see if that'd be okay, just because we're not taking him a walk in to leave this.
Okay, and if someone counsels, can you let me know?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Sure. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Call back.
Okay.
Okay.
Have a good day. Bye. Hey, babe. Okay, I called the vet. They can't take him today, but she said that she's gonna ask them to just refill those antibiotics that we gave him last time. So we can at least start with that. All right, love you. Bye. Okay, crisis averted. Let's get the AC on. Some music going. Let's do jazz today, I'm feeling it. I did it yesterday and I was so into it. It was so nice and like, let's do it.
problem with this is like if my little hairs come out, I look like that creepy guy from Charlie's Angels that sniffs the hair. Remember his like sketch hair? I like look like that if it comes out. So I have to like constantly. Maybe I need like little cute clips. Like cute. Okay, well, I didn't realize that today is like all lashes. So that was a hybrid fill. And now I have, again, my only mega set. And we're doing Brazilian, I think. She just texted me and told me that she has like no lashes. And I'm like, I don't have time to do a full mega set. So we'll see, I guess. Wiley, I brought my laundry, Angel. And you brought me ramen. And I'm so hungry. I never had breakfast. I'm a breakfast girl. If you don't eat breakfast, like start your metabolism. Do yourself a favor, eat breakfast. So I'm gonna scarf this down. Because it's 9:55 and I have 5 minutes before she gets here. I wouldn't even mind if she was like 5 minutes late. So Kayla, take your time. I'm gonna shishi, eat my ramen, and then get ready for this lash appointment. Cheeseburger because I'm kind of hungover. Pilgrim bun looking fine. I look back at the video though. This is supposed to go a little bit further back and it's crooked. It's fine though. It's whatever. I bet I still look better than a pilgrim. Dude, pilgrims will probably bust up. No joke. Oh, also, if you're wondering about our cleanse, we got about 4 days into the cleanse. And Waylea was like, my body hurts, my eyeballs hurt. So it just stopped it. And it's fine. I'm still like totally digging the way that I look. I would like to lose a little bit more weight. But I also want to have another baby. So like, you know, tit for tat. We'll figure it out. I only have one more appointment and it's at 2 o'clock for a full set of lashes. Sorry, excuse me. A full set of lashes, volume. This is not a flattering angle. Is the middle part not flattering for me? It's okay, right? I have a really small head, I know that. Where's Waylea? I want my burger. I also could really use a beer right now. Hair of the dog, right? Yeah, my hair is so scary. Showered in a month. Ew. Okay, so I'm finished for the day. It's actually only 3:30. I just turned off my wax, blew out my candle. I've got my laundry in the corner that I'm gonna bring home. There's a laundry machine here, but it's the weekend and I wanna just do it at home and then fold it and bring it back. I'm ready to have a glass of wine. For sure. My layup and I have been eating out so much lately. We like need to go grocery shopping and like eat dinner at home like normal people. Actually, you know what? I feel like it's like less normal now. Except for during COVID, like everyone ate at home, right? Maybe we just like cooked so much and like overdid it that now I'm just like, no. Also, we love our house. We're like really sick of that small, small kitchen. I'm just like, I'm so sick of making dinner in that little itty bitty kitchen. We really, really want to move. Less downtown. Our house is like on the way to everywhere for everyone. So we're always getting unexpected guests and drop-ins and I'm just done with it. Also, I used to have my spa in my house, so like everyone knows where I live. I'm ready for a change. And I think having moved out of that space for this studio made me like realize that. And we got a cute guest room going on. I'm in the middle of decorating it, but it's cozy and it's coming along and I'm happy for that. And like the house, we love it and it's so like comfortable. We have AC and our landlord is amazing. And like, I mean, we're so blessed, but I just like, I would love more space. It's just, it's pretty tiny. Our kitchen's like a quarter of a kitchen, maybe even less than that. You've seen it. It's like a nook. Like if you had like an RV, like a camper, that kitchen would be bigger than the kitchen that we have. I'm just saying. And like, I love our yard and there's so many things I love. It's just like the kitchen. But like, this is all stuff. Like we have a roof and like, we're so lucky and we can afford our rent, you know? And I feel like I said, I'm not trying to be ungrateful, but I can want things. I can have goals and that's just what some of them are. I'd love to make that happen like in the next 6 months, next year. If I just spent another year in that house, it wouldn't be the end of the world. But if not, you know, it's fine. Okay, enough ranting. I'm going to grab all my shit and I'm gonna head home. Honey, I'm home. And I'm drinking rosé. Hey. Actually, Wiley, I got this rosé for me at Safeway the other night. What even is it? It's this like pretty glass bottle and glass top. Cute, right? I just sent Wiley to the grocery store to get stuff for dinner. I'm gonna make like chicken with like a lemon wine sauce and capers, a salad, and roasted potatoes. So I just sent him to get that stuff. Me and Ellie are staying home and we're drinking wine, and well, I am. Right, girl? You looking at the rain? Hi.
Hi. I like to look at it.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Say that.
Say that.
Whoa.
Whoa. This child. Oh, I want to show you my guest room. It's not done, but it has a bed. So it's like.
B-B-B.
Wow. Okay. Is this your guest room for your guests? Is this mommy's old spa? You wanna sit on the bed? So here's it so far. Oh, have this like kind of little dresser. I just got it on Amazon. It has these like little drawers. Easy, and then this frame is just like a little metal frame, and this is like a mattress in a box. Whenever she wants music, she starts to sing the Frozen like melody. Doesn't necessarily mean that she wants that song, she just wants the songs. You having a nice time?
Hi. Whoa.
Okay. So the room is so small. Remember, it was literally, this was where my studio was. It's not that big. And then I have the closet here. And this is like one of my cubes from the spa, and I left it over, and it's kind of like, it's like a makeshift desk right now. It has like my printer and their iPads and like my computer, and then up here is just like supplies, my files, electronic stuff. And there's still space for someone if they want to like hang their stuff if they do come stay. You know, more office supplies. Looks cuter when you close the curtain. We don't have any guests. And we're like such like weirdos. We like our space, and our house is so small. It's like, I mean, if my family would like to come visit me, hi family, come visit me please. They could stay here, but no one visits us, so no one stays in here. Even though I've only had it in here for like a week, tops. Literally just got the bed we made it last week. Ellie likes it though, but has a seat. And I want to put like a big mirror on that wall, and then maybe some wall art. And I'd really like to take those shelves down. Waylea loves them, but I don't feel like they're very functional. Like, what am I going to put on them? I could put books on it and like make the shelves look cute, but it's not centered over the bed. It's like giving me anxiety. And I would like to get like a little TV just in case, you know, someone wants to visit and they want to like, you know, sit in the AC and like not have to be with my family. Me and Waylea and Elia. It's like a lot, you know, and sometimes when you're on vacation, you feel like you have to overly socialize if you're staying with a family member. So there's a nice place to retreat, and people like to watch TV. You know, I also have a computer with Netflix and stuff, but I think like a good small little TV would be like cute. I could even like possibly mount it on the wall right here. There's no plug, but I can make it work. Who are you talking to? Such a ham. Where do you get that, honey? You don't know. Oh, mommy's here. I had to take my pilgrim butt out because I was really like, it was starting to get really sketch. The pomade is not my jam. You know, no one wants to look like they have like sketch oily hair. And I like don't use a lot of products. So I don't have like dry shampoo or anything. I'm just like, just put it up, get it out of here because you look crazy. Do you look crazy? You were supposed to say no. I think she likes it in here. I want to watch Raya. They finally took it off of where you have to spend extra money on Disney Plus. You want to watch Raya, Elia?
The beach.
Yeah? The Last Dragon? Or the dragon or whatever Gabby. It's called? Yeah.
Gabby.
Let's watch. Mommy can have kiss? Mommy can have kiss?
Let's
she won't ever kiss me. Although I did read in a parenting thing that you should never ever make your child like hug you or kiss you if they don't want to. If they say no, or like if they like don't want to do it. They need to be comfortable that their no means something. And like in a world where there's unfortunately a lot of like sexual harassment, like it's important that they like feel like they have a voice and that their no means no, and that when they don't want to do something then they can say no. What? Yeah, but that they don't have to like, that they don't have to listen to an adult to do something like physically with their body if they don't want to, that they can put a stop to things and use their voice and not get walked all over or harassed or any kind of negative things. Right, girl? Are we gonna be assertive?
No.
Yeah, we are. We're gonna be super assertive. Assertive girl. Okay, let's go watch Raya. We're gonna wait for Daddy to get back, and Mommy's gonna drink her rosé. Oh, Peehee, are you coming? Of course he is. Oh my God, I'm so sweaty. Okay, I did it. I made dinner in my little kitchen. I made some food. It's a salad, balsamic dressing, potato wedges, and steamed purple kale, and chicken breasts with like a lemon wine reduction and capers. And there's my hun hun. And there's my bun bun. There's Ben trying to get flies. We're gonna eat. I'm hungry. We didn't finish Raya, but it was so cute so far, and I'm gonna watch it. I'm gonna sign off for the night. I'm gonna eat my dinner, drink my rosé, do my skincare. I'm gonna do it all over again tomorrow. Thanks for watching. See you next time. You're right.